gentlemen, Gungans and droids, are you ready for some more Imperial might? Woo! Moff Gideon is confirmed! Coming to Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes, let me hear it. Also, you guys want new content? We got new major Rancor rank changes coming to Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes! Woo! Get on over here, all you lovely ladies and gentlemen, Gungans and droids across the galaxy. This is a road ahead. It has been a while since we got a very good road ahead. Let's summarize what's going to happen. We have a Moff Gideon event coming. And funny enough, it's not even going to be a legendary event. It's going to be a marquee event. So we have a lot to talk about. They're kind of, I think, hinting towards a Beskar Mando legendary event. Hold your horses. Let's not get too excited just yet. Also, we're getting new updated changes for the Rancor raid. Like, holy cow. And they're saying it's going to be an unsoloable raid at launch. So Supreme Leader Kylo Ren orders, we can't break the raid. Day one. Very curious to talk about this with you guys. They're talking and giving us hints that they are going to be looking into the gear economy changes. So if you are happy with the new changes coming up with the double permanent double drops for characters in Galaxy Heroes, they're starting to look into ways to make the gear grind better for people. And we got some major 5th anniversary awards, and Relic 8 has been confirmed. We don't got a lot of details here, but it's coming. And I'm not big with new progression, with new relics, new gear, new mods coming to the game. I'm always a bit hesitant. We're not going to freak out at this post about Relic 8. We're going to see what's to come. And we got some Galactic Challenge changes happening. And apparently, a new major expansion coming to the Galactic Challenges sometime February or March next year. How does that sound? Does that sound like a nice plate to discuss over today, ladies and gentlemen? Woo! We're going to summarize these first two paragraphs here because we have a lot to talk about with the other 3 points here. It feels good. This is what Road Ahead should be. Not just, hey, we got Galactic Legends, see you in a couple months. This is what a Road Ahead is, ladies and gentlemen. First things first, 5th anniversary for Star Wars Galaxy Heroes are right around the corner. It's crazy to think. I've been playing this game for 5 years now, and many of you guys have been playing many years, sharing your journey with me and many others out there in the community. And on November 25th, they are going to be giving out the anniversary of rewards. Every year, they give out a nice batch of rewards. It used to be just Clone Wars, Chewie, a couple of credits and a couple of crystals at the first year anniversary. And progressively, over the years, it gotten better, giving you 20 Zeta materials, gear, crystals, and lots of other shards that are needed and whatnot. So I'm curious to see what they're going to be giving out this year. These never do disappoint. So be sure to check out, and I assume these shard economy changes are going to be happening on or about November 25th when they're going to give out the 5th anniversary rewards. And I want to give a slight clarification. Card in the top right-hand corner, there's a big economy change happening. As I said, permanent double character shard drops. And I tell you what energy, what materials, your bronze impacts, what you should be hoarding, what should you be spending. Highly recommend to watch the video, but I just want to do a little clarification. I forgot to specify with energy. Only hoard a couple of days before the update. If you hoard for 2 weeks, you're missing out on the free energy. So I recommend, as we get closer to November 25th, the other advice is perfectly fine, but just a clarification. If you're wanting to make sure you get the most out of this new update and you're farming characters with your energy, only hoard like 2 or 3 days before. Don't be hoarding for 2 weeks straight. Wanted to clarify that because that was a little bit of a boo-boo on my part there. But we already talked about the shard economy changes. Lots and lots of stuff. Probably one of the most exciting updates I've seen people react to this year. And the one thing I want to point out here, I don't want to go into the whole shindig how amazing it is that we should be able to farm characters twice as fast hypothetically moving forward here, but here's the thing I want to point out. We know many of you have questions around what's coming next. When I did that video, we broke down the news. This upcoming double shard drop is amazing for new players, mid-game players, but for end-game players, like, oh, this doesn't benefit me whatsoever. Well, I want to get something good out of this. Well, here they go. Here's the response to you guys out there. Rest assured, there's more to tackle in regards to the game's economy, but we need to see the results of these shard changes before committing to any future updates. Gear, ships, and event rewards are all being closely examined, and any upcoming changes will likely be discussed in the future State of the Galaxy or Road Ahead. And for the moment, we're excited to see how these planned changes to shards will improve the game and inform what other changes we can make in the future. My suspicion is that they're going to expedite the process, double the farming process for the character shards. I'm assuming the data is going to show that people are hitting the gear walls twice as fast. And how do we alleviate some of those problems, especially now that Relic 8 is coming closer? We need to find, here's, I don't want to go, we can maybe talk about this in a different video, but they need to
First off, allow low star characters to get the gear 12. This gating at gear 11 at low stars is dumb, especially when Relegate is coming around the corner. And same thing, let your 6-stat mods go on low star characters. But furthermore, they got to open the dial on that gear 11, gear 12 crunch. That's a really big pain point that people are facing. Stun guns, Mark 5 stun guns. Why don't we have a daily challenge yet that addressed that problem? So they're looking into it, and they're going to give us some more information in the future what they're going to be doing to tackle the gear economy. But here we go. Challenge tier raids. The Rancor raid severely outdated. People outgrow the Rancor raid extremely quickly in Galaxy of Heroes. And now we're going to be getting individual challenge tiers for the Rancor. Let's read this. This is the important stuff moving forward that we have not heard of yet. Yes, our old rubbery friend will be climbing back from the pit to give you a new challenge. After the response we saw from Assault Battles, we wanted to create something truly worthy of your rosters. We're still feeding the Rancor and don't know what he's going to look like at the end of his meal, but we know a few things. Firstly, the challenge tier Rancor will update the existing boss mechanics. Ooh, so it's going to be a new experience. The Rancor and guards will be getting a visual update, so it's going to look prettier than ever before. The challenge tier will be separate, a separate event from the old Rancor, and the goal is to make the new challenge tier unsoloable. So Supreme Leader Kylerun, you're not breaking this raid, let me tell you. At launch, in the future, there's a chance we're going to solo, but at the launch, Supreme Leader Kylerun will not solo it like he can with the AAT raid and the Sith raid. And last but not least, the challenge tier Rancor will reward Relic 8 materials. Again, I'm not going to freak out over this. I need to see the details, what it's doing, how difficult this is to acquire this. Is it going to be kind of gated a little bit like the new mod materials are? And we'll have another post next month to give specifics on the challenge tier Rancor so that players can prepare. Also have more on the relics in a post coming soon. It's weird because when they first introduced relics, the little demo video showed that at Relic 7, you unlock relic abilities. We still have not gotten relic abilities yet in Galaxy of Heroes. Maybe Relic 8 is going to do that. Maybe relic abilities are completely scrapped again. More to come in a post soon, but I'll just put this out there. Anytime there's new gear progression, mod progression, and now relic progression, I get a little squirrely. I'm not a fan of progression, especially since relics are only, a little over a year old at this point. So I'm not a big fan of progression, and relics already getting progression this late, I don't know. We'll see. Let's not freak out yet, but here we go. Mando Season 2 and Moff Gideon looking as beautiful as ever. The owner of Los Pollos Imperiales here. Mandalorian Season 2 is upon us, and we are just as excited as all of you. We've kicked off the new season by bringing two sentimental fan favorites, Queel, IG-11. IG-11 will be coming to Galaxy Heroes next week. You've already seen their kits and how they play, but we're excited to see what awesome combinations and squads the community can build with them. And here we go. The next character coming to Galaxy Heroes from The Mandalorian. Well, next we continue to season The Mandalorian content with one of the most requested characters from Season 1 of the show, Moff Gideon, leading a remnant of Imperial forces. Moff Gideon is obsessed with obtaining the child no matter the cost and wields a long-forgotten relic from Mandalore's past. Look at that beautiful Darksaber right there. Unlike Queel and IG-11, Moff Gideon will initially unlock from an upcoming marquee event, and we have more information to show in the coming weeks. Now, I was almost certain. They've hinted that the Mando characters, Mando, Greef, Kara, IG-11, and Queel, they're going to be leading up to, they're going to be needed leading up to something. And my suspicion was it was going to be Moff Gideon. They said, follow the story arc and you'll kind of answer it. And I was assuming it was Moff Gideon, but it's a marquee event. Marquee events don't have requirements like legendary. So firstly, it's great that people should be able to get their free 3-star Moff Gideon in the very beginning, but it seems like they're teasing that we're going to be getting a Beskar Mando. At least this is how I interpret it. Maybe we're looking too much into it. They said these characters are going to be needed for something. What is that needed something? And the only thing I can think of now, if it's not Moff Gideon, it's got to be Beskar Mando, because as we see here, and we've still got a few ingots of Beskar saved for some surprises, and there may be a few more friends coming from The Mandalorian yet. Stay tuned and see who else shows up to the holotables. They already shot down the idea that the child, Baby Yoda, is going to come into as a standalone character in Galaxy Wars. They said it's not the cards. That's not what they have planned. Unless they lie, they're trying to throw some smoke out there. I thought it was Moff Gideon as the legendary. It is not, but he is coming to Galaxy's. And man, look at Derek and the Garys back there. My predictions is that Moff Gideon is going to make the Imperial Troopers even better. We talked about this in a live stream the other day. I'm like, you know what? Piet and General Veers, they're good and all. But imagine if Moff Gideon took the Imperial Troopers to the next level. I'm hoping maybe for a Death Trooper rework to make his Zeta, his unique ability, a bit more applicable outside of Director Krennic. I'm pumped! I love this guy. I can't wait to see him come to Galaxy of Heroes. So stay tuned for more information on that guy. And lastly, we're wrapping this up with Galactic challenges. Now, the Galactic Challenge is kind of a lukewarm event. I've seen only very, very few people out of this world say, I love Galactic Challenges from the bottom of my heart. It's my favorite game mode. Me, I'm kind of in the middle. It's not my favorite game mode. I don't absolutely despise it. It's just something that it needs more. And they said here that there's going to be some big expansions coming. However, it's kind of interesting to see that they are kind of already adding an auto-complete option with the, or not option, an auto-complete feature with this upcoming Galactic Challenge changes. So firstly, let's read a couple things. They're adding the auto-complete functionality, new kinds of feats, and support for new combat mechanics, and they're going to be adding a new end-of-event reward mechanic. So to save you time and effort, we're introducing auto-complete. Short summary of all this is that if you complete Tier 7, if I understand this correctly, it's going to auto-complete all the lower tiers. So complete the highest tier, and that way you don't have to do the lower tiers, because when you're going through tiers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on auto, that's not really engaging. So do the most difficult tier you think you can do, and it'll auto complete everything under that tier. Then moving on with the introduction of the new end of event rewards, you'll now earn a new type of currency. We saw this currency in a data mine, I presume, from completing combat missions and their associated feats. As you accumulate this currency, you will earn a progressively better chest of rewards, which will open at the end of the event. So maybe this is one way of alleviating some of the gear crunch potentially. So that's we saw a little sneak peek of the currency not too long ago, and here we go with the instant payout of rewards. Players who complete challenges up to the higher tiers of difficulty earn all their rewards, even those which may not be applicable to where they are in the game from the earlier tiers. By making the switch to the end of event rewards, we'll be able to improve and differentiate the rewards offered as you progress from one chest to the next. So whatever you end up at, you're going to get rewards that most likely are going to be more beneficial to you. So that's kind of good that they're kind of tailoring the rewards a bit better. And last but not least, very vague, but they're eyeing the next major expansion of Galactic Challenges sometime in February or March next year. We've got some significant changes we'd like to make, but we're not far enough yet to discuss them. We'll be talking about them in our next Road Ahead. I wonder what it's going to be. There's Galactic Challenges needs a lot. I understand that this first iteration of Galactic Challenges was just the bare bones, the foundation for them to build upon the future. Let's hope they actually do build upon this Galactic Challenges. And we have a date, February, March, a little asterisk, TBD, you know, work in progress. So I guess we'll see in the coming future. But biggest news here, Moff Gideon, Mark Event. What's the legendary event or the event that the Mando characters are building up to? We only can speculate at this point. I suspect it's going to be a Beskar Mando. And man, challenge tier for the raids. Awesome, awesome, awesome. This almost feels like a Marvel Strike Force U7 raid. If you guys play Marvel Strike Force, the best way I understand this is that you have U7 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and 4 and 5. They really kick your butts. I suspect that's going to be kind of the same thing, of course, but the Rancor raid's a lot more fleshed out, a lot more thematic than the raids in Marvel Strike Force. So that's going to wrap it up for today. Fantastic post. We just got some question marks. How are we feeling about the Relic 8 coming to Galaxy? I'm a little squirrely, but we'll wait and see what that's all about. But nonetheless, I'm excited for the next few months in Galaxers, and I hope you guys are as well. Like if you did enjoy the video, comment down below on all your thoughts, and be sure to subscribe so you're not missing a thing. And one more time, it's great to be in the Empire today.